Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to have a little fun, get back to some basics again. We're going to talk about sonic paint. I'll give you some fun things to think about. I want to get back to basics because a lot of people are getting confused on sound. There's only three things our laws of physics tell us that are characteristics of and things that happen to sound energy in our world. It's absorbed, diffused, or reflected. Those are the only three. So let's try to keep, you know, this kind of paradigm in mind here, because these are the only three domains, if you will, that we have to work with sound energy. Hopefully we'll find life on other planets and they'll have some other ideas. That would be great. But to date, this is, you know, what we have to work with in our world. So three things happen to sound. Let's kind of look at each one and see what the impact is on it. Absorption and diffusion, you're all familiar with. You know, we're all really good at those two things. So these are two tools. So these are two tools that we use to really treat this energy. So these two characteristics, when it comes to sound, we can deal with that. We have technologies that can absorb and diffuse. It's the reflected energy that's always the problematic stuff. So we use two of the properties that happen to sound to kind of manage the third one, which is unwanted. Absorption and diffusion, we can live with that. We can add more, we can take some out, we can adjust depending on usage. But what are we chasing? What are we always after? We're always after the reflections. The reflections cause lots of issues. Speaker boundary interference effect, speaker too close to a wall, the energy between the speaker and the wall, comb filtering, similar situation, back and forth movement of energy at different frequencies, image in our two-channel systems, in our home theater systems, in our mixing and mastering environments, definition, separation, all this, RT 60 times, speech intelligibility ratings, it's all about reflection management. So we use two of the three properties that our laws of physics give us to really manage the third. And if I think you think about it in that way, think about it as sonic paint. You have absorption and diffusion technologies to manage reflected energy. And it's always the reflected energy, no matter what the usage. If it's mixing, mastering, control, if it's a church venue where reverberation times caused by lots of reflected energy or issues, you know, if you're trying to mix and master, if you're just listening, trying to keep, it's all the reflected energy from source and room. So reflections are a big, big issue. And how do we deal with those? We use absorption and diffusion. So it's kind of these are our laws, but we use two of the three laws to treat the third law. So that gives you an idea, kind of helps you understand the difference here. So in this graphic, we show that only three things happen to sound. It's absorbed, it's diffused, or it's reflected. And we're using absorption and diffusion to manage the reflected energy. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.